Hello, Hillwood.
I'm Brock.
And I'm Andrew.
And here's what's happening at HMS. Boys basketball is in action Monday against Coppell East.
7th grade is on the road and 8th grade is at home.
Wednesday is Popcorn Wednesday.
Bring cash for our salty snack.
Girls basketball returns to the court Thursday against Coppell East.
8th grade plays at home while 7th graders travel to Coppell East.
And that's the news. Here's what else is happening at HMS.
Hello, Hillwood. Old Man Nevitt here with an important public service message. I've been seeing all this stuff on the news about dangerous tic-tac challenges. Let me tell you something, people. Hey, listen. This is important. People's safety are at stake. The dangerous tic-tac challenges. Listen, people. Tic-tacs are not a toy. This is not a joke. These are meant for public health. They're meant for fresh breath. They have one purpose. And when you use a product in another way besides that, listen, this is important. No, Maddie, this is important. When you use a product in the way it's not intended, dangerous things can happen. So, you know, my cousin Ricky, he once got a Tic Tac stuck in his ear. You know how long it took that thing to dissolve in his ear and come out? It was 3 years. He couldn't hear anything out of one side of his head because he got a Tic Tac stuck in his ear. You don't play around and stick Tic Tacs in your ear or nose. Or, you know, maybe you think, oh, I want to see how many Tic Tacs I can put in my mouth at one time. Is this an M&M?
No.
Does it look like M&M's to you? No, it doesn't melt in your mouth. It doesn't dissolve in your hand. This is a Tic Tac. It has to be chewed. You put too many things in here. It's a choking hazard. You can get killed by a Tic Tac. Or, you know, you take too many of it at a time. One at a time. If you got really, really raunchy breath, like you ate some garlic and some onions, you know, maybe you take two, but no more. This stuff, all right, it's not a toy. It has maltodextrin. Do you know what maltodextrin is?
No, sir.
Me too, and I don't know. I don't know if I want it in my body. Maltodextrin can't be good for you. Or what about this? Magnesium stearate. Carbano wax. You want a carnauba wax? You want big piles of carnauba wax in your intestines and inside vital organs? No, there's no telling what could happen. You can block up. You might not use the bathroom for weeks. It could be terrible. And what if you say, hey, how many Tic Tacs can I throw on the ground? That could be really dangerous. It's a tripping hazard. They're very slick, all right? Very slick. You throw the Tic Tacs down. Ha ha, this is funny. Tic Tac challenge. I put a whole box of Tic Tacs on the ground. Now people are slipping, they're tripping, people are breaking necks, collarbones, all kinds of things, snap femur. It's dangerous, people. Don't play with the Tic Tacs.
Coach Nevitt, it's not Tic Tac, it's TikTok, and it's a form of social media, and people do stupid challenges on it and they actually end up hurting themselves. They're really dangerous. It's not Tic Tac.
Well, that's even stupider than playing with Tic Tacs. What's wrong with you people today? What's wrong? Stay off the TikTok. Go read a book. Do some homework. Go for a walk. Better yourself. Do something. Good gracious. Come on, people.
Hey, Hillwood, it's time for your HMS Book Challenge update. So far this school year, we have had 531 total books entered into the challenge. And the way that works is I'm looking at the percentages of what's the percentage of the Huddle teacher students that have entered books? So here are the percentages so far. Ms. Horton's at 1%. Coach Lorton and Ms. Beavers, they're both at 2%. Ms. Bass's Huddle classes have had 3% of her students enter books into the challenge. Ms. Bratch and Coach Butcher are tied. 5% of their students have participated. Coach Hickenlooper has had 7% of his students, and Mr. Berthold is in the lead with 15% of his students having entered a book into the challenge. So that's where it stands with the Huddle classes. I have decided to look at only the students who have entered in at least 10 books. So what that looks like is this. Our top students who have entered at least 10 books or more, this is our leaderboard now that we are halfway through the year. We have Ava Hurst, who has barely eked out a victory so far over Ella Street with 74 books. Sadie has 58 books. And then we have these other students who have pretty good number of books. Rafaela, 22, Abigail, 21, Kyler, 14, Angie, 12, Grace, 15, and Sophia, 17. So if you don't see your name up there, but you know you've entered books, that's because I only look at the ones from now on that have entered at least 10 or more. So if you'd like to get on the leaderboard, you've got to enter those books into the challenge. I know you're reading them. You just got to do the entering part of it. Hopefully we'll be able to have a nice little celebration with those that made the leaderboard at the end of the school year. The teachers have gotten on board again. Let's see. We've got Coach Nevitt, who's new. He's got 5 entered on there. Look at Coach Butcher there with 27. Mr. Berthold has 3. Ms. Deckard, 10. Ms. Constable, 3. So over here, I want you all to notice that I'm barely beating Mrs. Eckert, which is something I don't normally do because she reads like crazy as well. So right now I'm a little bit ahead of her, but come on, teachers, you know that you can do this as well. You're reading, you might as well put your books onto the challenge too. Let's all put our books in the challenge and figure out who our top readers are and celebrate reading. Y'all have a great day.
I know they